So wrinkly. Anywho, I put a payment on the card, a little one, $30, which was all I had left in the bank. I think I've got like 8 cents left of my overdraft or something, and that's it. Which I'll never get rid of. Dang it, I'm never gonna be rid of this thing. Anyways, I noticed that it didn't, it went through and all that, but there's a hold once again, magically, mysteriously, and for no apparent reason, there's a hold. So I had to phone the bank and have them send in a request for them to clear the hold. I think it's hilarious that if I phone the credit card company, they tell me the bank has the hold on it, and the bank says, no, it's the credit card company that has a hold on it. But yeah, they send some form to the credit card company, and they email it to them, and the thing comes off usually in a few hours. Which is good because then I'll have a total of $7 worth of credit left without going on to an overage. $7. Which isn't enough for coffee all month. Coffee is 2.50, and there's 4 trips for coffee would be $10. So, oh well. Probably end up on the overage anyways, because I almost always do. So, that's why I was hoping very much that this month I would get that $600 big payment thing, but it's never gonna happen. So, they changed that, and it's gonna start as a quarterly payment with the GST, I do believe. Starting in July, so it's not going to be all one big lump sum, which would be massively better if it was, but oh well. It'll definitely help. It'll definitely help a lot, but yeah. Well, at least I got everything I needed to order to date. So yeah, hopefully I won't need more things, and I will end up going on my overage. It's a certainty because I will need laundry soap before the end of the month. So I've got enough for one more or two more washes soon. So that's one more trip to the laundry, and then I'll be out and whatnot. So maybe I can hold off till next month. I don't know. But I've been wearing shirts and stuff for 4 days, it seems, 3 or 4 days. So being that I don't actually wear them all day, and being that I'm doing literally nothing, and I'm keeping it nice and nice temperature in here so that I'm not sweating ever. It's doable without being smelly. Anywho, I only had the water turned off a while ago here. I don't know what the hell that was about, but it was off. I don't know if it's turned back on. I hope it is, because yeah, I'm gonna need actual water eventually. So, I've got some in containers. I got a couple of containers of it in the fridge, just in case, because this has happened multiple times. So, you know, you're gonna have something to wash pills down with, or something to drink now and then, because you do need water. I think I just heard it coming back on. It's 10 degrees below zero outside, and it's Wind chill is minus 18. There's a 19 kilometer wind, which is not a huge wind, but it's enough to be noticed, that's for sure. I don't want to do anything today. I don't want to do anything. But I should probably do a couple of things. But I don't want to. And I'm probably not going to. That's the whole thing. I'm probably going to put it off. So, and that being taking a couple of things to the garbage that I didn't take the other day because they're new. Gotta check the mail today because it my daily aspirin stuff, my 81 milligram ASA is in Regina, so it should be here today. Unless something weird happens, it should be delivered today. So I generally check around noon, but the packages don't come at the same time the letters do, so I might have to go down twice, just because. No idea when the packages do show up, so it's in the afternoon. I just know that. So if I went down around 5:30, it should be time enough for them to get everything done. And I'm still waiting for a package from the States, which is probably seriously delayed. Everything from the States is seriously delayed. So, you know. Yeah, freedom fighters. Let's block border crossings. The best thing is the mandates are going away rapidly all over the country, and they knew this, but that wasn't the objective. The objective was to literally overthrow the government, and they actually had it on their webpage that that was their goal. So then they realized that most of the country was going terrorist at their general direction, and they changed their directive. Anyways, I see they've updated the American government readiness thing, has updated their information on what to do in a nuclear attack. That doesn't make me feel all that secure that it's recently been updated, as of the 25th of last month, actually. So, It's basically in the event of nuclear attack, all done for. God. Think humanity needs a reset. There's too many of us around anyway, so I'm kidding. I wouldn't want to survive. I wouldn't want to survive at all. So, because life would be hellish, and I wouldn't be able to get my meds, so I'd be way sicker than I am now, and I'd be half dead in no time, anyways. So, you know. Plus, relying on what's left of a government after that would be next to impossible to. Do to actually rely on them, so you know. Not to mention the definite possibility of nuclear winter for at least a few years, which means no crops, which means no food, which means the cattle die, which means no meat. Yeah, not a good situation. Yeah. Anywho, not all of us can afford to buy 6 years worth of MREs or something and hide them in a bunker someplace. So, anyhow, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day and keep smiling.